Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. I'm here with my girl, Dani Canada, deputy editor of BOSSIP. And there's so much that's going on in Hollywood this week, honey. The people have been very busy.
Very
busy. So we just got to get started.
Let's start.
Let's talk about Rob Kardashian and Evelyn Lanzada. Is there a thing there or is this a strategy?
So Evelyn Lanzada is friends with Rob Kardashian. Little did we know that.
Basically,
she sent out some steamy tweets to Rob, and one of them was about his anatomy. And he tweeted her back, and it sparked dating rumors. People are wondering what was going on between them. She went on The Breakfast Club and she basically said it was a dare. We are friends. You know, I was just joking. I wished him a happy Father's Day. And he dared me to post that on Twitter. And then Rob tweeted back. And so there's this whole thing going on there. But she did admit that she would date him. She was like, well, he's a nice guy.
Really?
Why not?
Yeah, I don't really see
would
that.
Would you date Rob Kardashian?
No. No, I wouldn't. I just...
That's your type?
Not really interested.
Yeah.
No, I don't I don't know him personally or anything like that, but not really my
style. I think she thinks, you know, he would, like, worship the ground she walks on, and I'm sure he would, but, you know.
The girls go for Rob, honey, when they need a strategy, That's just me, honey. That's just my tea. That's what I'm saying. I could be wrong. But anyway, let's talk about Jordan Woods. What's going on with Miss Jordan, honey?
So Jordan is the topic of discussion on Keeping Up with the Kardashians. You know, this whole thing happened with Tristan Thompson. So on this episode, Kylie Jenner told her sisters that she's scared of Jordan. Because she was worried that Jordan could wake up with a smile and act like nothing happened during that alleged hookup with Tristan. So people were like, you know, how could you say that about someone who is your best friend? You know, but Jordan's remained classy.
What does she mean about being afraid?
She said basically, you know, you played it off like nothing happened. Kim said you should have been at Khloe's doorstep begging for forgiveness, and she didn't do that. So they said that it's scary that she could just play it off. But according to Jordan, of course, nothing really happened.
Well, maybe nothing happened.
Right.
But how many things have happened with the Kardashians?
A ton.
And other people.
A ton. So now people think that Jordan is being shady now. So Jordan starred in a commercial for Ray J. And we all know Ray J's history with the Kardashians. So basically they were saying that she did this to be shady, but Jordan said herself, no, I'm just doing a favor for a friend. I wasn't even thinking about those girls, and I believe her. I think she's just being nice.
Okay, well, can't she just make her own
money? Can she make her money? Can she make her coin?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
That's what I'm saying.
All right, so let's talk a little bit about ESPN. Okay, and LeVar Ball has been banned?
LeVar Ball was on ESPN, and he was talking to Marley Karam, who is the wife of Jalen Rose. And he said something very inappropriate to her. She said, let's switch gears here. And he said, you can switch gears with me anytime. And there was a pause there, and everyone kind of just looked around like, did he really say that? So now ESPN has banned him. They don't want to work with him on any platforms in any way, shape, or form.
You know, everything is not about a joke. You understand? Everything
just,
is not about being flirtatious.
And
you know, just be professional.
She was obviously uncomfortable.
This is a married woman, of course.
Right. She tried to joke and play it off like, oh, maybe I need to call HR, but HR really did step in. And
maybe
they said,
HR down to the ESPN.
Right. They don't play
radio.
Those games. So they said, we're going to get rid of him. He's not coming back on.
All right. Well, let's go ahead and talk about Kimora. Unfortunately,
it's
some baby daddy drama
So Jimin Hansu is the father of her son, Kenzo. And he told photographers,
so
basically, he's adorable, that he hadn't seen his son in a long time. He really wanted to spend Father's Day with him. And he hinted that Kimora is keeping him from him. According to Kimora, however, that's not true. She said she has an open door policy at her house. She has great relationships with all the men she's dated. Of course, Russell Simmons. And basically, if he's not seeing a son, according to her, it's because he's not coming over. He has rights to come. She's not banned him from coming. So there's this drama
there. I didn't peg him for being that type of man, though.
He's been really petty, and I didn't see that for him.
Wow, you never know the people, huh?
You never know. Like, I've never pictured him lashing out and talking to
photographers. Still thinking about him on Amistad.
Right. Give us free. That ain't free.
I understand that. Okay, let's move on. Mona Scott and Jersey Shore, honey. The people down to Jersey Shore, they're bitter. They're all in their feelings. What's happening?
Okay, so MTV had their movie and TV awards, and Jersey Shore lost to Love & Hip Hop Atlanta.
Okay,
so they were in the category reality TV royalty. Love & Hip Hop Atlanta took home the title, and according to Jersey Shore, that's incorrect. They're like, this is our network, basically. We've been on here for years. People were trying to say it's because they think Love & Hip Hop is too ratchet, and Mona Scott Young got really petty, and she said, they sure are upset, aren't they? They sure are salty. So it was really cute, and I thought that was funny, but...
Well, you know, she was just setting the people straight. You understand what I'm saying? Let the people win, honey. Let the people live. If you don't make it this time, you might make it next time.
It's right. Okay. Just because you're a star don't mean you own it.
Exactly.
I hate when the people think it's a star and something that they own it. Several seats, stadium seats, and a nosebleed.
Oh, come on now.
All right.
Please.
Moving right along. Let's talk a little bit about Basketball Wives. There's some issues here with Shawnee O'Neal and Jennifer. What's happening?
So Shawnee O'Neal, you know, she keeps it very classy, mm-hmm, but she has some issues with Jennifer Williams. Last season, Jennifer Williams helped spread this rumor that her friend Evelyn Lozada hooked up with Shawnee's ex. We all know who Shawnee's ex is, Shawnee O'Neal's ex.
Okay.
So
the one she was married to.
Yes, the one
then.
She was married to.
Okay,
so
then.
Mm-hmm. Instead of being apologetic this season, Jennifer's like, well, what's the big deal? He allegedly slept with a lot of people. And really ticked Shawnee off. That made her
very angry.
It did. So when Jennifer showed up to Shawnee's event, which is actually for her son, Shawnee stormed out. A bunch of people went with her because she was like, I can't be around someone who's disrespecting my family.
Wow.
So she and her ex have a great relationship now.
But I thought her and Jennifer were friends at one point.
They were, but Jennifer's been really shady lately.
Reality TV, ain't that something?
Right. People will do anything for a little camera time.
Reality TV, honey. They be in and out with each other, don't they? They love conflict.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't that something? All right, let's move on. Let's talk a little bit about Oprah. So
Oprah's
maybe bringing back her talk show. I'm here for it, honey.
So Oprah admitted to Entertainment Tonight that she misses her talk show.
Mm-hmm.
She said, you know, I would like to come back, maybe not every day, but we had something great for 25 years.
Yeah.
Maybe I will come back and do it. So that is something everyone would love to see.
Absolutely.
She basically said anytime something big happens in the news, she gets a little sad because she's like, I can't report on it. I'm not on TV. So
maybe
I would
once
totally
a week?
Be for it. Maybe once a week. Why not? She could
do a
podcast.
That. Yeah.
She could come back online. She could do Instagram Live. I would watch Oprah. I'd watch her do anything.
I love Oprah.
You know, that's my girl.
She's always in the kitchen,
too. Oh, that's TSU.
Too.
That's you.
You understand what I'm saying?
All
you
right
better,
now.
Girl. You better know your history. Yes, well, Daddy, it's always a pleasure, honey, with you coming here and giving us all of the tea. For more, like on these stories, you can always follow Danny on Bossup.com.